guys, welcome back. Today let me show you how I built this lumber rack for my shop. You can apply the same design principle wherever you need heavy load bearing shelves for books or something. This design is called cantilever design. You can Google that to learn the physics behind it. But for now, let's begin the build. I started off by a very obvious step, which was to clear the area along the wall of all the clutter. Then I marked the stud locations on the wall. I built almost all the rack with rough lumber. I cut 2x4s to the desired length for the cleats and then ran them through my table saw to shave off the rounded edges. That will ensure the super tight connection of the brackets with the cleats. Then I marked the center of the 2x4s and pre-drilled holes for the screws to attach these to the wall. Next, I marked the locations on the wall where the cleats would go. Next, I attached one cleat to the wall, making sure with my level that it was pretty darn straight and level. I then attached the rest of the cleats in line with the first one. Next, I cut 2x4s at about 12 inches, which would be the depth of the brackets. Then I devised a temporary jig for my table saw to cut 1/2 inch thick plywood at an angle for the brackets. Next step was to assemble the brackets. I made a small simulation setup as if I was attaching these brackets to the cleats, but only upside down. I hope the video makes it clear how I assemble them, but let me try to explain though. First, I attached the plywood to the 2x4s with 18 gauge nailer and then reinforced that with heavy duty nails by hand. Assembly of the shelving was pretty straightforward. I don't have a video of me attaching the brackets to the cleats, but let me try to explain. In each row, I attached one bracket to the cleat with two 2-inch long construction screws on both sides and then attached the rest of the brackets in that row level with that first one. I repeated the same process in all four rows. You can see the finished shelves well loaded with lumber. They are very sturdy and can take quite a lot of load. This is a very good design for wherever there is need for strength. I hope you guys enjoyed this project and learned a thing or two from it. If you did, you might want to subscribe for more such projects. I'm Sujata, Muri's handy mom, and I'll see you guys next with another useful DIY project. Until then, take care.